Have you ever been victim of a crime? I know it can be very painful. And I know because we were victims of a crime, my husband and I, last week. And I want to share with you what happened to us. But most important, I want to share with you what are the normal reactions and emotions and what to do. What you can do for a better and faster recovery. Living in harmony is possible if you know your emotions and how to handle them. I am Dr. Carmen Román, and I will share with you the current psychology by myself or by interviewing experts who will inspire you. Learn how to live a life of fullness and how to recover your emotional harmony. Welcome to Emotions in Harmony. Hello, how are you, my amigos in harmony? I hope you are doing great. This is another episode of this podcast, Emotions in Harmony. And of course, you have it in video, in Facebook and YouTube, and now in the podcast. Yeah. This is Carmen Román. I am a clinical psychologist, and my work is to make your life better, emotionally better, so you can live in harmony. Isn't that fun? This week, I don't have such a fun topic. I'm so sorry. This week, actually, I don't have fun news. This week, I am going to share with you my experience of being somebody broke into our house. So this is my experience I am going to share with you. And I am going to share with you what are the normal emotions and what is something, simple steps that you can do to recover. Because my expertise is to work with trauma, with victims of crime. So do you think it helps when it happened? Kind of helped me when it happened to me, but I definitely learned a lot through these beautiful conversations with my clients that are recovering from a crime. So I'm going to share with you that. And hopefully you feel inspired and share your stories and contact us and, you know, just use this episode for whatever you think is appropriate for you or your loved ones. Share to whatever suffered an assault, a robbery, sexual abuse, whatever, somebody who suffered from a crime. Yeah, please share. What are the normal emotions of an event like this? First of all, let me tell you a little bit of what happened to us, and then I will kind of wave this topic into it. What happened to us is last week when I opened my garage and parked nicely and I opened the second door from the garage, I saw everything on the floor. I mean, they open drawers, they throw stuff, pieces of glass. Literally, like when you see in the movies that somebody is searching for a particular document in the movies, and that was my house. And it feels horrible. It feels really helpless. Yeah. Oh, I feel like an ant, like beautiful, very powerless. Yeah, I feel like beautiful, beautiful ant. Like a tiny bit, like, no, what I can do. And probably I scare the people who were in our house. Probably I scare them when I open the garage. So this means I interrupt them or I miss them for a second, probably. So that was even more scary. So when I open and I realized that that was kind of fresh happening, I immediately went outside. And thank God it was the police taking care of something else outside already. And I could call them. There were three officers there, very near to my house. So I knew, I mentally had that information. I went back and grabbed them and they came and they actually went in for me. They searched the house fierce and they stayed outside because at that point we didn't know if they were in the house or somebody was in the house. The only thing I knew, it was that my cats were inside and I didn't know how they were doing, if they harmed my cats. Oh my God, this is such a difficult feeling. I knew my husband was okay at that time. So those are the normal reactions. This belief that this cannot be happening to me. This cannot be happening to me. How come? Oh my God. Yeah. This cannot be happening in general, not to me. In general, this cannot be happening. The second is the survival response. It's like you want to run or stay and fight. Yeah. And I wanted to stay and fight because I knew my cats were inside. I didn't know how my cats were doing. So I wanted to stay and run and see what you guys are doing to my cats, yeah? And my brain worked harder than my instincts. And I ran outside to call the police, yeah? And the police was, they asked me to wait, and I wanted to come inside again to check on the cats, but they didn't allow me. So, ooh, survivor response. And if you have an incident and you respond the way that you respond, that's okay. Because people may say, why you did that? Or how, why? Yeah. Well, it doesn't matter why. You can be compassionate and kind to yourself and say, this is how I respond, period. Yeah. It's not an event that we practice. It just happens and we respond the way we are. I truly believe that mindfulness and exercise and self-care has an impact in how we respond. Because my mindfulness helped me to think, Carmen, go and ask for help before you check on the cats. That was the very moment that I am very appreciative of all my mindfulness and chanting and whatever I do. Fear is a normal response. Because, of course, your heart starts racing, your stomach, you start sweating, of course, because you don't know what is going on, yeah? So fear is a very normal response. Even though we are brave, fear is okay. Anxiety is okay. Anger is okay, yeah? And negative thinking comes later. When we have negative thoughts about what could have happened, is normal, yeah? And if we know it's normal, we can actually pay attention and stop them on time. If you have negative thinking and you see, oh my God, they could have done and that and that and that and that, then you are torturing yourself. Don't do that, please. Just stop and say, I don't need to torture myself. This is already hard enough. And the other things that I am thinking didn't happen. So don't go there, please. Confusion, you will be confused. And that's okay. You will not be able to focus, and that's okay. Yeah. Even the police was asking me my phone number. I couldn't even remember my phone number. They were like, because it's normal, because your body just went through all of this survival response. So don't ask your brain to know stuff that you normally, this is why probably they train us to have the insurance information nearby in the car, or the phone number in the fridge or whatever, because our brain doesn't work properly in times of this intense fear. So it's also a couple minutes later, you can start expanding your feelings of gratitude. Whatever happened to you, there is always something to be grateful for. I'm so grateful I was not here, or I am so grateful I came 20 minutes late. Oh, I am so grateful my husband was not here. I am so grateful the cats were okay. Oh, I'm so grateful the three police members were already outside. They came in and checked for me. Thank you, San Jose Police. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I received the royal treatment.
And the woman police.
And the woman, Barajas. She spoke to me in Spanish. Oh, I love that. And very good Spanish, by the way. I love that. It's important. Thank you, Officer Barajas and Torres and the other one and the community service officer. They were all so kind to me and to my husband and, of course, to the cats. Oh, thank you. This is very important, yeah, because we are in this stage. Wow. Actually, Officer Barajas said that I was calm, and I say, well, this is my job to listen to other stories, so I kind of can breathe and stay calm. They were with us for 3 hours and they were taking fingerprints and all of that and all these questions and all these numbers and electronics we need to report and all of this. It was challenging. Please, I'm going to give you a list of what to do if you are in the situation or after, yeah? And listen to it. Even though you don't need it now, please listen to it, because when you need it, you have that in your brain. First of all, be careful with yourself. Rule number one, stop and think about how you can care for yourself. you don't want to run after the guy who is taking your phone or your purse. You don't want to run after or follow somebody in your car. No, because you are putting in danger yourself more than that person already put you in. You don't want to fight back. And I am Aikido. I am Aikido trainer. Oh my God, of course, I can do something with my hands and with my body. But this is, my skills are to put me on a safe mode and not to harm. They are not to do something to people. So if you have the resources, use the resources for yourself. In the moment, think about who you can ask for help. Of course, immediately 911. Immediately run outside. Immediately look for help. Immediately interrupt somebody. Don't be shy about asking for help. Actually, when it's a robbery and you are inside, the recommendation is to start yelling fire, 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 because people will respond more to fire than a robbery. Yeah? If you say somebody came into the house, they will run. But if you say fire, they will try to help. Whatever you need. Yeah? So after a couple hours later or after the event, you and your family members can clean up together, because you will have the feeling of, I don't want to be alone. So it's okay to be cleaning up together. Understand that there's going to be hours of cleaning. I was able to call in the middle of it, even when the police was still looking for the guys inside. The first thing is I call my clients for that afternoon to avoid them to drive to my office. And one of the clients asked, when you are going to see me next? And I said, I don't know. I don't know. Thank God, I'm just barely calling you right now, yeah? Because remember, mental confusion is normal. So be sensitive. Be sure that you are going to be sensitive and you can take care of yourself. Worry about your being calm and centered. Yeah, do something for you to be calm and centered. Breathe. Drink water, or in my house, they say eat some piece of bread. Pamper yourself. Go to the bathroom, whatever you need to do to compose yourself, because it's going to be a couple hours of long process. Yeah. Make, if possible, cuddling and hugs and everything you need with your family members. It's okay. The police know they are doing their stuff, so you are allowed to take care of yourself. Return to your routine as much as possible, as soon as possible. Some friends, for example, say, do you want to come and sleep with us in our home that night? And I say, no, because I'm going to be totally afraid to sleep that night in the house for sure. I was really afraid. But it was the best way to conquer my fear and stay. And I knew I was safe. I knew it was going to happen the same day. Yeah. So staying there, we all were like together. There is one cat that doesn't sleep with us, and he was really together with us that day. He slept together with us, so he was really near to us for the next couple of days. Take time to make sense of what happened. Remember, not being able or disbelief is normal. So take time. Take time to go and do something for yourself. Talk only to the friends and family that you trust and care, and that you know that they are going to be kind to you, yeah? The ones that are not kind to you, first of all, I don't know why are your friends, yeah? And the family members that are not kind to you, don't talk to them. I mean, maybe you don't want to tell to them ever, but especially not after this incident, because they are going to criticize you. Or the ones who will be too scared to listen to your story, don't call them, because no need for you to scare them. In the Latino community, we have the bad tendency sometimes of just blog, just talk the story with details. It's not needed. Yeah. First of all, you really need to tell the story many, many times. Your friends can listen many, many times, but don't share details that don't let them to rest or sleep, or it's not need. They already traumatized you. Why you are going to traumatize other people? Yeah. Don't do that. Even in therapy, when they want to describe, they describe the first time, okay, I understand. But if they want to keep describing in very, very detail, no need, because they are re-traumatizing themselves and they are re-traumatizing me. So choose the story that you want to share and is important for you. Or more, probably you say, we were been robbed, this is what happened, period. But don't go into traumatizing details. It doesn't help. Allow time for yourself to go through the place, to explore, because your brain has questions. It's like a curious child. Everything changes in our routine, yeah? They move this, they move this, they open that drawer, they took that. So allow time, please, for you to walk around and make sense of what had happened. Allow time for the children to go around and ask questions. Allow time for your pets. My husband and I, we were through everywhere, of course, with the police. They walk us through and we together. We make sense of it. And then when they left, we were sure that it was no pieces of glass anymore in the floor, whatever. We went and took a walk through the house with the cats. So they were smelling everything. Yeah, everything. They wanted to make sense of everything new. So that's okay. We went with them. Take care of yourself on food and sleeping and rest. We were in the middle of it. The police left 2-3 hours later and we didn't have lunch because it was a lunchtime. So after that, I told my husband, we are sitting and having something to eat, and especially tea, and especially something sweet. So we make time for tea and sweet and something to eat. Because in the middle of it, before we start cleaning, because we knew that the day will be long, will be very long. So it doesn't help to be hungry and sleepy and tired. So we relax for 10, 15 minutes and then we keep going. In the afternoon, I make another space for us to have dinner. In the afternoon, it was already the construction worker here. And it was already, people were already rebuilding the windows and blah, 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 blah. So it was a lot going on in our house. Yeah. So it was important for us to be well nurtured and nourished. Yeah. I was talking to friends. I couldn't even talk to friends at the beginning, but I was talking to friends in the afternoon. I traumatized a little my friend Brenda, yeah, because we talked like 10 p.m., something like that, before you went to bed.
Yeah.
And Brenda couldn't sleep, and I slept nicely because I talked to my friend. Yeah. So it is good for you to make preventions. Everything that you can make to make you feel safer. Cameras, new windows, new locks, new whatever is for you and you can afford.
Crocodile.
Yes, hiring a crocodile and whatever I need. Yeah, bringing a crocodile into your home. This is your suggestion.
In front of the door.
In front of the door. A dragon.
Yeah.
Forget about cameras. I'm going to hire a dragon. And it will be fire if somebody wants to come in. Actually, in my meditation, not joking, Maestra Brenda. In my meditation, I already put a lot of angels. I normally do put angels in the home. But I already put dragons too.
Okay.
Yeah. So whoever comes without my or my husband permission, not going to be good.
It will be good.
It will be there, taking care. I love what my sister-in-law said. May their bacon be born forever. Yes. So do whatever you need to do. Take the jokes, take the conversations, whatever you need to do to recover. The more you do, the faster will be your recovery. Please, please, please go and take therapy if you need to. Because the therapist is the expert in helping you and actually pinpointing whatever you don't think is a result of the event. Because you may not think. You may think, that event happened many years ago, but I still cannot pass through that corner or through that street. I cannot drive. I cannot see people of that color of skin or men or blah, blah, blah. So it's normal to have all of these fears and you need to work through it. If it was a sexual assault, people many years later still cannot have a normal sexual relationship. So it's good to know all of this. Yeah, I have an episode on trauma. You want to listen to that. Well, this is all what I have for today. Thank you, thank you, thank you for listening. Please share your stories, comment, be with us in this process, and especially be with you if you were a victim of a crime. Share this so others can help themselves. and we can all live in harmony. Bye for now. We have reached the end of another episode of the podcast Emotions in Harmony. See you the next week. Visit www.emotionsinharmony.org, where you can subscribe, find the notes, and be in direct contact with me. Thanks for listening.